यूनिट वन गाइडेंस इन मॉडर्न सोसाइटी। गाइडेंस इन मॉडर्न सोसाइटी। गाइडेंस इज नीडेड बाय एवरीवन। टुडेज वर्ल्ड इज हाई टुडेज वर्ल्ड इज हाईली कॉम्प्लेक्स इन एवरी स्फीयर ऑफ लाइफ। टू बिगिन विद वी हैव द फैमिली व्हिच हैज चेंज इट्स मैनी ट्रेडिशन कस्टम बिलीव्स वैल्यूज एंड एटीट्यूड्स। देन द स्कूल एंड द मॉडर्न सोसाइटी इन 21st सेंचुरी। द इंडिविजुअल इज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय हिज फैमिली हिज एजुकेशनल एनवायरमेंट एंड बाय द सोसाइटी। देयरफॉर इट इज गुड टू हैव अ लुक इनटू दोस एरियाज एंड द चेंजेस व्हिच हैव टेकन प्लेस इन देम। टू लिव इन अ सोसाइटी वी हैव टू सी द कस्टम ट्रेडिशन एंड बिलीव्स एंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ दोस सोसाइटी व्हिच हैव बीन चेंज्ड। वी शुड गेट सम गाइडेंस अबाउट देम सो दैट वी कैन लिव इन दैट सोसाइटी। फैमिली सम फीचर्स ऑफ द फैमिली इन द 21st सेंचुरी। ब्रेकअप ऑफ द जॉइंट फैमिली, न्यूट्रल फैमिली, सिंगल पेरेंट, डाइवोर्स पेरेंट, सेपरेटेड पेरेंट्स, वर्किंग पेरेंट्स, बोथ द पेरेंट्स, चेंज इन द ओल्ड ट्रेडिशन कस्टम्स एंड फैमिली वैल्यूज विच हेल्दी फॉर द इमोशनल सिक्योरिटी एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ चिल्ड्रेन। द नॉर्म ऑफ वन चाइल्ड और मैक्सिमम टू चिल्ड्रेन, द पोजिशन ऑफ द चाइल्ड इन फैमिली, द इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस ऑफ द फैमिली, सर्टन बिलीव्स एंड सुपरस्टिशियस। As the world has shrunk, so has the family. With the breaking up of the joint family system, nuclear families have increased. The traditional old system was a large family or a joint family. While if we look at family setup today, we find that majority of them are a single unit with one child or maximum two children. The son separated from the parents and established on his own. A loneliness prevailed in their life. If we see the previous family system, most of the families were joint families. But now with the passage of time, with the passage of modern society, there are now nuclear families. Nuclear families have increased because many of the sons prefer to live alone, take their own houses and live in that. The breakup of the joint family has resulted in two major economic problems of the well-being of the life. The first one being the lowering of the economic standard of expenses. The acute housing problem and the slum dwellings could have been eased if the practice of the joint family continued. The physical, psychological, emotional and social insecurity of the members of the family. In the joint family system, there is a strong physical, emotional, and social support system. The breakup of the joint family system has caused considerable harmful the psychological point of view. There is a loss of genuine love and affection among the children growing under one roof. There is a tremendous scope for sharing everything from food to clothing, from study to play, from secret to suggestion. The joint family system now in modern time, in modern society, there is no joint family system. There is the nuclear family. So there is a great loss when the joint family system has broke up, because from joint family system there is a great support. If anybody get harm or if anybody in problem, there are many people to tackle with that. But in nuclear family, the child or the person feel loneliness. Most of the cooperation, team, spirit, making, sacrifice, coordination and so on can be imbibed without any conscious effort on the part of individual. Even if there is a loss of parents, there is some elderly person in the family who take up the role and does not let the individual suffer. There may be a few disadvantages of the joint family system, but from the guidance point of view in a country, link are where the resources are limited and population is uncountable, unemployment exists even among the educated. The joint family system was a blessing in disguise by an old count. It means that there is some advantages and disadvantages of joint family system. Joint family system is necessary from guidance point of view, but we can see that most of the team cooperation or spirit making and some sacrifice these things can be done. These things are needed in joint family system. Look into our family today where both parents are working. In order to maintain a certain standard and provide basic amenities to the member of both family, both parents, the father and the mother need to earn. This means that both of them are out of house 8 to 10 hours of the day and return only meals at night and for rest. Such a home is not a congenial environment for children to grow in, for it can be compared to a boarding house where people mainly gather for food and rest and exchange a few greetings without influencing one another. A home for children should provide acceptance, warmth, loving care, affection, and full-time attention for their well-being. By providing the physical amenities, many parents feel that their responsibility is over. What children need, especially in the early years of development, is psychological and emotional support, a feeling of being secure, and having the mother of their side. In today's family system, in modern society, mother and father both are educated and both are doing jobs. They spend 8 to 10 hours out of their houses and only return to their houses at the time of meal, at the time of rest. So they are not giving much time to their child, and there is many distance in one home. The child and the parents live in one home, but there are many distance. So our children at early stage require many of the care. The child require care and attention, which is not given by the parents, because mother play important role in child's life. So from mother's side, the child is not getting care and the child start being insecure. Fact remains that because the mother goes out to earn, she keeps a servant to the housework, to do the housework, send clothes to laundry, get clothes tailored or buy ready-made clothes, arrange a tutor for the children, gets food from outside, and if she wishes to cook, she needs to store food in the refrigerator and so on. In nuclear family system, mother and father both goes out. Although father, the job of father is to earn. It is the responsibility of father to earn. But the mother also goes out to earn. So she keeps a maid in house so that those maids can take care of their family, take care of their child. So there are many distances in this case. This all the service at home, like cooking, washing, and tutoring the child, which could be done systematically, efficiently, and intelligently by the lady of the home, for the physical and mental health for the members of the family, are left entirely to hired labor. More than this, is a danger is that when mother is away, the child are left without any control, and they loiter around or spend time at the corner of the street or remain at a friend's place. At that time, they may become delinquent and chronic drug addict. At this time period, when a child see that there is no one to keep an eye on him, he start going out, he start going to involve in some negative behavior, bad company. Because he know that there is no one to keep an eye on me, he goes out of the street, different friends, the child make different friends, negative friends, and keep bad company. These days, child abuse is common and it may be happening among one's relative. Here is a wise piece of advice for parents. Please do not let children stay away in your friends or relative house. If you are not with them, there are some parents who send their children to their friends and relative house in far away places during holiday. These opportunity for child abuse and cause permanent damage to the child and their further. Here is the matter of child and the parent. The parent should not send their child for holidays at distant places, because this is not good for child. They at small ages, the child mind is very sensitive. They are attracted towards, they are very curious about knowing the things. They are attracted towards things, so it can be cause the negative behavior on the child if parents send the child out of the house for holidays or for other. So it can cause a permanent damage, because the damage that is caused in early age of the child, in their childhood, is the major damage that results with them till their adulthood. So this is the crucial period. At this time, the parents should keep an eye on their child. It is important to explain to your children when you're not able to spend much time with them because of work commitments. Tell them you too are disappointed. Give a simple factual explanation or the work situation. Focus on how disappointing it is for you both for not being able to spend time together. Give the children something to look forward to But be realistic. Do not promise to take them for an outing next Saturday unless you are very sure that the work pressure will be over by then. While you are waiting for the treat, throw into the conversation, I am really looking forward to next Saturday when we are going for an outing together. It was look it. To our 21st century family, we find in many of their interreligious and intercaste marriage in deep trouble, and children become the victims. Therefore, proper guidance is a must before and after such marriages. In this paragraph, it is explained that if you are not able to spend some time with your child, then you should explain them the situation, that this is the situation. And I cannot give you some time due to my work, due to my hectic routine. So you have to manage it. You don't have to go in bad company. You have to explain your child about your situation and also give them some factual explanation about your work situation, and don't give them fake promises that if you will do this, I will take you at next Saturday to this place. In 21st century families, we have found that there are many marriages that are not according to the, that are not willingly happened. So there are many these marriages, due to these marriages, children suffer a lot. School guidance is more important while the child is at school and is undergoing a rapid development, physical, mental, moral, social and personal. Though the girls develop and mature earlier than the boys by the age of 16. Boys have attained physical and mental maturity and have developed a pattern of interest and personality trait which may remain almost permanent with them. By now, they have finished their general education and they are on their way on work journey for professional and technical training. Therefore, it is an established fact that guidance has to be given at school so that children can pursue their higher study according to their interest and aptitude and help in their further development. We know that girls develop and mature earlier than boys. The maturity age of girls is almost 16. Girls start maturing earlier. At the age of 12 to onward, the girls start maturing. But the boys' maturation age is 16, 17, 18. And this time period mostly of boys is spent in school, in their school life. So it is important for teachers to give them a proper guidance, because after this age, some students obtain their professional life, especially boys. Closer view at the education system in the 21st century. Schools and colleges with very high standard providing high quality modern facilities, including human resources and mental resources. School and colleges with high standard, with average standard, school and colleges without any standard and any facility. Most of the remote villages without any school, education institutions which charge exorbitant fees, lack of quality teacher. Today, this is an overview of 21st century educational system. Poor method of teaching, mass approach in classroom, commercialization of education. In many cases, higher education and professional courses are bought by the money power rather than on merit of the student. Too many pressure for the parents and for the student. You can see that these all are not the terms, but these all are not the talking we are saying, but these all are the facts. It is a fact that today in 21st century, this is our education system. With the problem of overpopulation and crowded city, most of the existing schools can't provide a healthy atmosphere for the students. The infrastructure and resources for the school are very limited according to the ever-increasing number of students. Most of the old well-established schools' classrooms were made to accommodate maximum 20 or 30 children, but now those classrooms are bulging beyond capacity and may be accommodating 55 to 69 students. Not to maintain the other facilities like sanitation, drinking water and a large enough playground. In such crowded classroom, the people spend 6 to 7 hours sitting up on stiff chairs on benches at times, or benches at times, and in some cases without proper lighting and ventilation too. The school curriculum with many subjects which are not according to their choice bring in a lack of interest for learning along. In this paragraph, it is explained that in old times there were some institutional classroom built and their accommodation was 20 to 30 students only. But now, today, in those classrooms, 55 to 69 students are accommodating. There are not facilities, as to schools are not giving us the facilities. So, the education system, the population is very much, and the classes are overcrowded. Interesting methods of teaching by the teacher naturally. There would be restlessness and undesirable behavior on the part of the children. There is no homogeneity among people in a class, and therefore, mass instruction become too easy for the intelligent and too difficult for the slow learners. Problems crop up when indifference is shown by these two extreme groups, and the class as a whole may suffer with regard to the rate of exposure of or the unexpected or expected accomplishment. Large classes are difficult to control, and more so when there is not sufficient place for the free movement of the teacher from one end to the classroom to the other. Today, teachers have lost their tenure, and what was earlier the guru-chela relationship, the reverence and respect of the teacher has been totally reversed. It may be a good question to ask: have today teachers become more commercial-minded than service-minded? It means that some uninteresting method are adopted by the teachers so that they can communicate their knowledge to the children. Some students do not take part in class due to their low IQ level or due to their low understanding level. They are not so much intelligent. On second hand, the classroom are not big enough. They are not spacious, so there is no space for the teachers to move in class, to move from one corner to another corner to keep an eye on the student. Genuine dedication and the zeal of the teachers of the past to care for the weak student and to help in the overall development of all the people are rarely seen now. Teachers with missionary zeal and real mastery of their subjects are rarely seen. The education courses have also served from the preparation of specific job requirements so that after completion, the people still find themselves at square one from where they began and gain employment. So the people do not see the value of education when they find that it is not going to lead them to a definite career. They just get restless and perhaps drop out of the educational program out of sheer disgust. In such a situation, guidance is needed to make them realize where to halt in a general academic education and where to start teaching vocational training for taking care for their future life. In old ages, when the education was most important than the other thing, the teachers were very sincere with their profession. The teacher always try to solve the problems or queries of their people, and the teacher have some missionary zeals that I have to do this, I have to see my dad's student so that he can do better in life. But today there is no, the teachers are not so much competent, or they are only just passing their time in educational institutes. If parents will do anything in order to give a good education to their children and put them in such schools which may not suit their pocket of the father. As a result, the mother also start working in order to bring additional income. This can again have a negative effect on the family, and the mother find no time to care for her husband and children. Parents need guidance in the selection and choice of school that have a good curriculum and are according to their budget. The modern aim of education are fivefold: lifelong learning, early productivity, quick money, sensitivity to the social economy environment, self-actualization. In order to achieve these aims, a well-organized guidance program is needed to make the individual aware that what he learns today will be outdated tomorrow. Therefore, he needs to be open to the new learning and be a perpetual learner. Early productivity and quick money making are the needs of the day. He has to plunge in vocational preparation immediately after secondary school stage and enter the employment market by the age of 18 so that he gets full 40 years of work life. In due time, he'll become an expert in his field early in his life, and his productivity will increase and be a self-fulfilled person for himself and for others. He has to develop sensitivity connectivity for the downtrodden, the destitute, the elderly and the handicapped. This is very much needed in our country where there is illiteracy, poverty, caste system and religious taboos which separate human beings from their own fellow men. Once he has fully become developed and made use. If we want to achieve this all aim, we have to organize some guidance program which will guide the students to make them active learner. They will guide the students at every stage of life because we have studied that many boys join their professional life at the age of 18. So the guidance should be given, the guidance program should be arranged for the students. Opportunities available for him to excel himself in life and to serve his family and build a better society. We can see that he has achieved self-actualization in his life. This is 21st century. The need for guidance is felt much more in the education institutions, for the authorities are aware that their efforts will yield results only if proper guidance and service is provided. The 21st century society. The following are some of the characteristics of 21st century society. Changes in the family system, challenges of permissive society, gap between the rich and the poor, poverty and unemployment, unequal opportunities, corruption in various areas of life, decline of the value system, caste system, globalization and advanced science and technology in every sphere of life. Focus our attention on the social and cultural, scientific and technological milieses in which our children are growing and developing, the breakup of joint family system, the change in the tradition and value system of family life and midst of the families being a single unit are some of the main features of the modern family. The 21st century is permissive society where the boys and girls move freely as compared to the older system where girls lived under the protective care of the parents at home. Even in the diet, there has been a drastic change. Girls rarely consume tea or coffee, but now every pub and cafe are filled with freely moving girls and boys. Girls and boys move out for dance, music and other entertainment and they participate in these freely, which were not done earlier. The permissive society in the 21st century has many adverse effects on the life of the youth today. These are some drawbacks of 21st century. That it is a permissive society. Girls in older time were not allowed to move freely outside or in the society. But today the girls are always ready to compete boys. They always stand with boys and move freely in the society. Today there are many cafe or pubs and music and dance and other entertainment are also common in which the girls take part. Proper guidance is needed without delay. Overpopulation, illiteracy, child labor and unemployment causing frustration among the educated and the uneducated are a big burden. And suffering in the modern society, the gap between the rich and the poor is increasing instead of lessening and the poor people feel the injustice of not being sufficiently cared for or protected by the government. When children see around them different standard of living or are themselves suffering from the lack of daily bread, shelter and unemployment, they grow bitter and develop hardened way of dealing with those who are around them. If guidance is not given at the correct time, they may grow so offensive that they may harm their development. Today in modern age, there is a much gap between the rich and the poor people. The poor people are facing injustice by the government because they are not given with the proper facilities and their rights as rich people are consuming their rights. So the child of poor people, the children of poor people, when they are not receiving their equal rights, they feel themselves that they are low. They feel themselves that their standard is low. So they grow bitter and they always go towards doing bad deeds or towards wrong things or they harm themselves also and other also and their growth and development go towards negativity. Fact to be considered is that the individual does not have an equal opportunity in the society. Though equality is accepted by the democratic socialistic setup of our country, yet in reality there are innumerable imbalances and prejudices in all areas. Other typical injustice of unequal opportunity is noticed in the work situation. Though the government through legislation has provided for the recruitment into commercial industry and government concern through employment exchange and strict selection board. Every individual is aware of the fact that the employer will have his own person, and if it is a private industry, case has his own nominee and as the executive or the manager. This creates a lot of work as subordinate under bosses who have neither the caliber or qualification to man the seat. In today's society, individuals did not have much opportunity in the society. There is much unemployment in the society and there is injustice. The jobs or the employment is not selected on the base of merit or knowledge. It is just based on money. Our system and the communal feeling are so deeply ingrained in our culture that the unequal opportunities and other discrimination are also seen in other areas of development as well. At every step, the individual faces several odds and needs to have built-in resources to face reality and weigh fact of life to summit them and not crumble under their burden. Only guidance alone can help him to guide over the difficult periods. Another cause for concern and anxiety is the declining of value system in our 21st century. Dishonesty and corrupt practice are the way of life for many. The character is no more as a trend, but money is considered as the power of character. The wealthy nations dictate the poor and underdeveloped nation. This part state that today there is a great difference between people. They are always seeing they are busy in their caste system. They are always criticizing each other on their caste and color, etc. This is most common, and so this lead to dishonesty in our society and a corrupt society. Those who have seen to make a success in life have been able to do so by corrupt practice. A sincere, honest individual can never reach the peak of his power or the highest position unless he was political connection. The deep root of corruption has spaded into the temples of learning, and those who can afford can buy a seat in the best professional college, get the best degree with the least effort. Children see around them all such corrupt practice and feel despondent and discouraged to work. In this whole paragraph, it is explained that corruption is very common in today's society. Children learn that everything is gained through corruption. Our seats are gained through corruption. The merit, there is no merit base. The seats come from corruptor. There is corruption practice. They learn very soon how to get quick money and how to indulge. In today's society, the children don't focus on their knowledge. They always focus how to gain money and how to use their money so that they can get some higher rank or some better place in some company. At this stage, the guidance must be given to the students so that they can be aware, they can made aware of the fact that corruption is not only the thing, the corruption is not good thing that they are doing. They should earn, they should do, they should qualify at their own basis and on their own effort. Educational problems. There are innumerable problems related to the people's physical and mental disabilities or to his interaction with other in the education environment, like the teacher, classmate, undue pressure, and so on. Disinterest in studies. The people hate to do any schoolwork and reluctantly come to school. They look forward to holidays under slightest pretext, takes holiday and pretend to be ill. This is common in student that especially in small students, in early age student, that they are not interested in going to school and make lame excuses that I have stomach pain, I have headache, etc. Sudden drop in scholastic performance without any apparent cause. He just cannot cope with the studies. Some students drop out their studies, failing a certain subject consistently even with high potential may make a low grade due to disinterest in schoolwork and therefore put in the least effort. Least effort over achiever who with limited potential exert a lot to make the grade with the help of tutor for each subject. Slow learner, people who really unusually slow in their overall pickup. Then we have the scholastically backward people, a child who is 2 years older than the average age of the class and has already repeated once or twice in the same class. These people may sometimes be a nuisance, sir, to the teacher as they show their presence in the class by noise and antisocial activity. Scholastic backwardness could be due to a variety of causes. There may be a stray cause of a mentally retarded child in the class. Here are some problems of those child who repeat a class more than one times, or they repeat a class twice. So they cause problem in the class, cause noise, which is not appropriate for other member of classroom, and also the teacher is also disturbed by those students. There may be another group of people found in a school who have no goals in life, no ambition to motivate them to study. There are certain education problems which spring for the interaction of the people with the teacher and of the people with one another in the classroom. Partiality shown by the teacher and injustice as seen by the people is no longer tolerated today. The other psychological and behavioral problems also interfere with the scholastic performance. What is the best method to teach and develop positive relationships so as areas of education guidance? The importance of such guidance can be seen more seriously when one realizes that during the school. In this, there is some students don't have ambition of their life. They have no goals of their life. There is no one for them to motivate them towards the study. So some teachers show partiality or injustice between people, which is not tolerated by the students today. And sometimes some psychological and behavioral problem also interfere with the some scholastic performance of the students, and this has a great impact on the students' academic. The individual has a maximum all-round development from age 6 to 16 in all aspects: physical, mental, social, personal, moral, and religious. And therefore, if he gets entangled in any problem, his total development would be hampered on almost permanently. From this age, individual from 6 to 16 age, this is the most important period of a child development. You have studied in previous unit about the child development, and you also know that what are the crucial period, what are the important period of child development. So these from age 6 to 16 are child physical, social, and the development from all aspect is very much necessary. So if any error occur in this development, it will be hampered almost permanently. The development would be hampered almost permanently.